Hi, welcome to Go Language for Tourists. Now, this is my complete Udemy course that I'm finally able to post here on YouTube. This is something I've been wanting to do for months. It just took me a while to get it together and have the time to be able to do it. But here it is. Now, there are a few housekeeping things. First of all, I'd like to thank all my subscribers. You got me to this place. You still make it something that I want to do. So thank you very much. If you're watching this video and you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. If you're already a subscriber, please spread the word. Thumbs up the videos as you go through the course. Definitely leave feedback. I welcome feedback. For those of you who've already supported me through Patreon or bought the course, thank you very much. If you'd like to show some support for what I'm doing here, there are a couple of ways you can do it. You can go to my Patreon page and support me that way, or you can still buy the course on Udemy. That's another way of still supporting me. And of course, if you can do any of those things at the moment, it's a pleasure to be able to have you be interested in a course and to take the course. So enjoy. One final thing is how the course is structured here on YouTube compared to how it's on Udemy. All right, so let's cover what's different between how the course is presented here on YouTube versus how it's presented on Udemy. On Udemy, I can provide the lecture notes plus supplemental materials, but I can't really do something like that here. So instead, I have re-encoded the videos such that for a section, you have all the lectures. And after each lecture, you may have an exercise video telling you about the exercise that goes with that lecture. And then at the end of that section, you have a lab. So to make that clear, let me say it again. For each section, there are several lectures. And at the end of some of the lectures, you have an exercise. And at the end of the section, you have a lab. So all those videos have been encoded so that it's just one continuous thing. And if you look in the description below, you'll find a link to this GitHub page, github.com/striversity/GLFT, which is golang for tourists. Now, if you come to this page, you can see that I have all the code that we develop. So if we're in section two, for example, you'll find that our section two, when I'm in lecture one, this is the code that I develop in lecture one for section two. And you can find the code there. And similarly for any other lecture four in section two, there is the code that we develop, and I explain it, of course, in the lecture video. Now, I mentioned that every section has several lectures, but what is this stub and solution directory? Well, if you look in stub or solution, they both have the same format. You will see exercises, and this is what I talk about. After the end of each lecture, there's an exercise. So this means exercise 01 here is for the lecture one in section two. Exercise four is what you're gonna do at the end of lecture four, and so on. Now, why the solution directory? Solution directory is where I provide you the complete solution. Keep in mind this is programming, so they might have several ways of doing something. And so this is one possible solution. The stub directory contains a stubbed out version or a partial solution, and you're expected to complete it. I strongly suggest that you start with the stub and see if you can complete the exercise. And only if you're stuck or you want to compare your solution with mine, then you should check the solution directory. And the same thing goes for the lab. Remember, lab comes at the end of a section. So after you go through all the lectures and exercises in section two, then I expect you to be able to do the lab. The lab is going to be based on everything that we've covered in this section, on possibly things that came before, so that we keep building on what we've learned so far. So we keep adding on to it. Okay, I hope that makes sense. And if you have questions or concerns, definitely post them, and I'll do my best to try and get back to you in a timely manner so that you're not stuck. Okay, take care. Thanks again, and enjoy the course.